Hi there and welcome back to Japan, and I'm taking a little bit of a risk on the next one. This was recommended by, I've got to admit, usually I don't remember who recommends this song, so apologies, but this one I took particular note was Dean Grant, who recommended this, who's always been a great commenter. I like the fact that, just like myself, he never 100% always comes down in favour of everything, so we have some interesting debates. He's one of the guys like you who I enjoy talking to on here, and he recommended Team Shachi, and the link he gave me was to a song called I Don't Care. It appears to be live, in which case, damn it, Dean, you know that I don't do live songs first. It's a bad way to introduce me to a band, but I'm gonna go with it anyway. Maybe they don't have any music videos. I've never heard of them, and they didn't appear to be like a massively viewed band online, so I'm expecting something a bit different here. I can't remember what video you actually recommended them off the back of, Dean, but this is one where from what I'm aware of, I think they're like an alt-idol group. Anyway, I'm going to stop waffling, I'm just going straight into it. The fact that I don't know anything is just going to make this more interesting. So this is Team Shachi with I Don't Care, I believe, if I remember properly. Wow, I come across with so much professionalism, that's what makes this wonderful. Go! This could go anywhere. Oh, saxophones. Guitars, synth pop, saxophones, idols. Where's the harpsichord player? Here comes a hook. That's a good hook in a weird way. It's a bit full on, like just blasting away your ears, but it's fun. I gotta admit, the quality of the live recording's kind of bad. I like the synth riffs and the little touches in this are fantastic. It seems they have put in a lot of little crazy sections. So it's not just an easygoing pop song, it's a really packed to the brim arrangement. And it's even the brass members who are so central at the beginning have just wandered off now, so someone can seemingly clean the stage. Sorry, are they meant to be cleaners in the background? It looks like someone's actually sold the venue while they were doing the show.
Oh,
This is a very docile dubstep bridge. I guess we have no idea where this song's going to go next. I think we should just admit this. It's just so weird. What's going on? It's just... Are we going to just demolish the building at the end? What the... Sometimes I say there's a lot to unpack. I don't know if there's a lot to unpack there, or if it's just going to take me some time to get my brain around it. My head's floating. I guess the first analogy, to use an obscure analogy, the first analogy that comes up, and thank you so much, I'm really glad that you gave me that link, even though I have some qualms about how it was recorded. The first analogy that comes to mind is there was quite a while when I first moved to Tokyo, when I was staying in a hostel, and there was lots of travellers who'd come through, and for about 6 months I basically just sort of helped them out as a tour guide just for a bit of fun, you know. And it was just something I did on the edge, and it just gave you someone interesting to talk to, and you get to see their perspectives, and it makes everything fresh. And a lot of them have been to, you guys might notice, it's very famous in Western Tokyo and Shibuya. There's a thing called, it's like a robot cafe, robot show or something, where it's just all like neon lights and everything. And if you ask anyone who's been there what it's like, they basically kind of reply, well, it's not something you can describe, and it's not something that you can really just take a photograph of. It's totally... totally overwhelming, and it's something when you see it, it's kind of more something that you carry with you afterwards, as just being like, yeah, that was strange. That's how I feel about this. I'm not really sure that it's easy to quantify or qualify verbally what the qualities and issues with this were, because it clearly takes itself so tongue-in-cheek that it's hard to know how seriously they're doing it and where to approach it from. And yet at the same time, the song has so much in it, so much thrown at the wall, that clearly that was not just spewed out in 30 seconds like a cheap idol song. And no disrespect, you know, you can have simple songs that are brilliant. But this song was just so many weird things happened in it. And the performance seemed rather disconnected. And it does seem that maybe the idea was that the entire stage and the entire venue was pulled apart whilst they were doing the song. I have no idea why. The lyrics were too quick for me to translate. So maybe it was a song about demolishing venues during gigs. I have no idea. But it was a real experience to watch. Is it the sort of song I go back and listen to? I think without the joy of seeing the video, and this is why I kind of have to say thank you for suggesting the live video, although, like I say, it was very badly recorded. The bass was booming way too much. A lot of the detailed sounds were crushed underneath it. It was hard to really hear the music in the depth that I think it was actually recorded originally. But in seeing the live video, you got a sense of what the group were in a way that kind of made it more... more possible to enjoy it with that, knowing how tongue-in-cheek the whole thing was being presented. If I was thinking about just listening to that again, it would be kind of hard to think of it wanting to listen to it, because it was a kind of a whole experience, and the madness of the song played into the madness of the performance. It's kind of like if you went back and listened to a soundtrack for a movie. You can do it, and it kind of works, but in some way it's never going to be as good as the first time you heard that music accompanying the actual movie itself. So I'm interested to hear more of this group, just to see what the hell is going on. Whether they just demolish all of their venues, or if maybe in the next song they rebuild it. Do they have any music videos? God knows what happens in their music videos, if that's what happens in their live show. The performance, you know, like I say, the performance was pretty good. You know, none of the voices stand out as being amazing. The song didn't have a hook that stood out as being amazing, but the band were fun. The song was certainly kept you on your toes and kept you interesting. It was all kinetic, it was all energetic. There was lots of little details. There's everything from harpsichords to little quick blasts of saxophones before they went off to demolish the venue. And, you know, just little bits of everything. It, like I say, it worked as an experience. Whether it worked as a song and a video and a show is a hard one to judge. I think you'd really have to depend on the mood and the context. But as an experience, that was quite an experience. Like I say, I can't really dive too much into the music simply because of the fact that I think that would be missing the point to a certain degree. But anyway, thank you very much. As always, drop comments. Feel free to tell me more. I know nothing about this group at all. And rather than just Wikipediaing them, or going to like official pages, I prefer to learn from you guys. So tell me what you know. Tell me what's interesting. Steer my judgment. And if you think there's more I can watch that will add to the experience, obviously, I don't want to watch two videos that are too similar. If you can think of something which is a very different song or a different context or a music video or a performance where they do something which maybe compliments this, drop it my way. I would be interested to hear some of their studio work, actually. But anyway, for now, from Japan, ciao.